Hello students, I am Varsha Dias from Adarsh Education Society. I am a science teacher for this academic year 2020-21. I hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to start with first chapter, that is the living world adaptation and classification. I have divided this chapter into two parts. First one is adaptation in plants and second one is adaptation in animals. So in today's video, we are going to learn about adaptation in plants. In what different ways is the diversity in living things seen? Before answering to this question, what do you mean by diversity? Diversity means existence of variations of different characteristics in a group of things. For example, plants, animals, people, etc. The diversity in living things is seen due to their different shape, size, color, and different structure of the body. Great variety of plants is seen on the earth. Some plants have colorful flowers. Some plants grow in water, whereas some plants are found to be in deserts, which have scarcity of water. Scarcity means shortage. Some plants are found only in snowy regions. Snowy region means an area which is covered with snow, where there is a snowfall. Some plants cannot be seen without a microscope. That means some plants are very tiny. They are very small, whereas some are huge in size. Like plants, animals too show diversity. Some are unicellular. Unicellular means organisms made of only one cell. For example, protozoa, amoeba, paramecium, etc. And others are multicellular. Multicellular means organisms which are made of many cells. For example, human beings, fish, trees, flower, monkey, etc. Some are vertebrates, whereas others are invertebrates. Vertebrates means they have vertebral column, backbone. For example, fish, birds, reptile, amphibians. And invertebrate means they do not have vertebral column, backbone. For example, insects, protozoa, etc. World is full of a variety of animals, like aquatic means the animals which lives in water. Terrestrial means the animals which lives on land. Amphibians means the animals which lives on the land as well as in water. Reptilian means the animals which crawl. For example, snakes, lizard, turtle, and alligator. And an aerial. Aerial means birds fly in the sky, etc. Are the plants and animals from Kashmir and Rajasthan are of the same type? Can you elaborate on any differences between the two? Coniferous trees like pine and deodar flourish in snowy regions like Kashmir. Why these trees flourish in snowy regions? Because these trees have conical shape. When snow fall on these trees, it does not get accumulated on these trees. It immediately fall down because of its conical shape. However, in the desert of Rajasthan, plants like cactus and acacia, that is babul, are to be found. The camel, a desert animal, is not found in Kashmir. What is the reason for these differences? Because the temperature of these two places are different. All the plants and animals at these places are also different. Animals in Kashmir are with thick fur. Their body is changed to suit the cold climate. Rajasthan being the desert, animals like camel are seen here. According to the local conditions, the plants and animals show different characteristics. Gradual changes means slow changes occur in the body parts and also in the behavior of organisms, which help them to adjust to their surroundings. Such changes are called adaptations. They take place over a long period of time. For example, if you are moving from Rajasthan to Kashmir, you need to adapt to the cold temperature. Initially, you might suffer from cold cough, but after some time, your body will get adjusted in that environment. Plants grow everywhere on the earth. We can see plants on hills, deserts, and also underwater. So, first we will see adaptation in plants. In that, first one is the adaptation in aquatic plants. Some of the aquatic plants are firmly, firmly means tightly rooted in the soil at the bottom of the water bodies. Water bodies like oceans, seas, and lakes. Their stems are submerged. That means their stems are underwater. We cannot see them. While leaves and flowers float on the surface, we can see leaves and flowers of aquatic plants as they are on the surface of the water. However, some plants are entirely afloat. That means their roots, stem, and leaves float on the water. Their roots are not anchored in the soil. The surfaces of leaves and stems of many aquatic plants are covered with a waxy layer. For example, if water falls on the surface of leaves and stem, it will not get accumulated on the surface and stem because of waxy layer. Leaves of some aquatic plants are thin and slender, like a ribbon. This shape helps them to withstand fast currents of water. Means, because of this shape, plants do not get affected by fast currents of water. Air spaces in stems and petioles. Petioles means the stalk that joins a leaf to a stem of aquatic plants are useful for floating in water. Now, second is the adaptation in desert plants. Take two potted plants, one a cactus and the other a leafy plant. Tie plastic bags loosely around the leaves of these plants and keep them in sunlight from early in the morning. In the afternoon, bring those pots into the classroom and observe them. Has the same quantity of water collected in both bags? If we will observe it carefully, we will see that the amount of water collected in both the plants are different. In a leafy plant, the amount of water is more, whereas in cactus plant, the amount of water is less. Desert plants are either leafless or their leaves are like small needles or have been modified into thorns. That means their thorns are nothing but their leaves. As a result, they lose very little water by evaporation. The stem stores water and food and is therefore fleshy. The stems are green as they perform photosynthesis in the absence of leaves. Now, photosynthesis means the process of food production in plants. Their roots penetrate deep into the soil. It means that their root goes deep into the soil and some roots spread away into the soil in search of water. There is a thick layer of a waxy substance on the stem of these plants too. Next one is the adaptation in plants of snowy region. In what way are sloping branches useful to plants in a snowy region? When snow falls on the branches, it naturally falls off from the branches and does not remain on the top of the tree. Therefore, as an adaptation, the plants in a snowy region have sloping branches. Plants of snowy regions mainly includes coniferous like deodar and pine. These trees are conical in shape due to their sloping branches. In the heavy snowfall and extreme cold in these regions, their conical shape prevents the snow from accumulating on the tree, and the thick bark, bark means outermost layer of stem, helps the tree to withstand the cold. Next is adaptation in plants of forest region. A variety of plants, trees, shrubs and herbs are found in forest. We have already studied about trees, shrubs and herbs in previous standard. These plants compete amongst themselves for sunlight. Hence, trees grow tall to get sunlight. And climbers. Climbers means plants that need support to grow. And vines, any type of plant that climbs or grow along the ground and has twisting stem, grow to a great height with the support of trees. Spring like tendrils on the stem of some climbers is an example of adaptation. Next is the adaptation in grassland plants. Diverse means different types of bushes and grasses are found in the grasslands. Fibrous roots of grasses prevent soil erosion. Now, there are two types of roots. First one is tap roots and second is fibrous roots. As you all know, grass have fibrous roots. It holds the soil firmly and help to prevent soil erosion, means destruction. Forest in the equatorial region, equatorial means near the equator, are dense. Animals like tiger, elephants and deer can remain hidden in these grasses. However, grasses in cold regions are very short. Animals like rabbit are found in such grasses. Vast meadows. Meadows means an area of land with grass and other wild plants in it, are found in hilly areas as well as plains. And the last one is adaptation for ingestion of food in plants. Ingestion means consumption of food in plants. Most of the plants are anchored in the ground and are autotrophic. Autotrophic means plants which make their own food in sunlight. However, plants like dodder are parasitic. Now, what is parasitic? A plant that derives some or all of its nutritional requirement from another living plant is called parasitic. The plant body of dodder consists of yellow wire-like stems. It is leafless and cannot perform photosynthesis. That means they do not have leaves. Hence, they cannot prepare their food. However, it has haustorial, that means sucking roots for absorbing nutrients from the host plant. These roots penetrate up to the conducting vessels of the host plant to absorb water and food. That means dodder plant do not prepare their food. For food, they have to depend on other plant, that is host plant. Now, how they get food and water from the host plant? The roots of dodder penetrates, goes down to the vessels of the host plant, and from those vessels it absorbs water and food. Fungi do not have chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the substance which helps in the production of the food in plants and cannot perform photosynthesis. Now, from where do these fungi get the food? They obtain food
from starchy foodstuffs like bhakri and bread. They have root-like fibers, thread kind of thing, for absorption of food. With the help of the fibers, they absorb their food. Plants need nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium for growth. Plants that grow in soil which is deficient means lack in nitrogen, like Drosera, sundew, Venus flytrap, peacher plant, etc., fulfill their needs for nitrogen by consuming insects. Such plants are also called as insectivores. Adaptations are seen in these plants which serve to attract insects and hold them captive.
I hope you all understood about adaptation in plants. We'll see you soon with the next part of this chapter. Thank you for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe.